ninth meeting of the GST Council, and we've started on the leftover agenda of the last meetings. There was a presentation made by the Secretary, Ministry of Power and Non-Conventional Energy, as also certain other officers, as to what they consider should be the tax regime for the power sector. The Rates Committee will take an appropriate decision on that matter. Thereafter, the issue of cross-empowerment and dual control was taken up, and we discussed this issue for the entire day, and we've been able to arrive at a decision on this issue. The entire taxation base will be shared between the assessment and machinery of the center and the states. It will be dealt with in the following manner. All assessees with a GST turnover of 1.5 crores or less, 90% of them would be assessed for the purposes of scrutiny and audit by the states, and 10% by the administrative machinery of the center. Those above a turnover of 1.5 crores would be assessed in the ratio of 50-50 between the center and the states. To repeat, the states would do 50% of the assessees above 1.5 crore turnover and 90% of those below 1.5 crores turnover. The center would do 50% of those above 5 crore turnover, above 1.5 crore turnover, and 10% of the assessees below the 1.5 crore turnover. Intelligence-based enforcement powers will vest in both the center and the state assessing officers. The above division will empower the, will relate to scrutiny and audit. The power to levy and collect the IGST taxation is with the central government, but by a special provision in law, the states will also be cross-empowered in the same manner of the ratio mentioned earlier. In the exercise of IGST, where there are contentious issues between conflicting states with regard to place of supply, etc., obviously one of the states can't assess, and therefore those assessments would necessarily take place by the center. As far as the area 12 nautical miles into the territorial waters is concerned, it's a part of the Union government territory. But as per convention, the states will be empowered to collect tax on any economic activity in this territory. This decision has been taken after very wide consultations. There was initially a proposal made by the chairman of the CBEC, which was discussed with all the officers of the state and the ministers. There were some issues with regard to this. There was an alternative proposal made by the minister from Tamil Nadu. Eventually, that proposal became the base proposal. It was debated upon, improved, and finally agreed upon. All the ministers present agreed to the proposal, except the West Bengal minister, who disagreed to the limited extent that assessments below 1.5 crore which are divided 90-10 between the states and the center, his dissent was confined to the issue that it should be 100 versus 0 and not 90-10. On all other proposals, he also agreed. Having resolved this critical issue, the ministers then worked out the time schedule. The agreement today will have to be incorporated by suitable changes in the different legislations. This will have an impact on the IGST law, the compensation law, the SGST and the CGST. The drafts of those laws, which have been tentatively approved by the council, will now be firmed up, discussed between the officers, and will come up for consideration before the GST Council on the 18th of February. Once those drafts are approved, they will go to the respective legislative bodies for approval. Simultaneously, after they are free from the preparation of these drafts, the officials who are lending technical support will start working out on the fitment of the rates into the various slabs. This exercise will, for all, in all probability, take us well into the month of March. The ministers in the council then assessed a realistic date by when the three important things pending, final draft legislations and the rules, secondly, approval of these by the legislative bodies, and three, the fitment of the rates can take place. So I requested the ministers to give their opinion about the realistic dates. And there was a broad view that the 1st of July appears to be more realistic, since it's a transactional tax. It can be introduced at any time. Also, they felt that the industry and trade will have to be given some adequate notice. And once the rates are decided, the systems of the GSTN will have to be modified suitably. So our next meeting will be on the 18th of February. This long gap is because A, the drafts are going to take some time to be finalized, and B, most of the finance ministers, including myself, would be busy with both the central and the state budgets.
Khuda ke bande samal ja, waqt hai abhi badal ja. खुदा के बंदे संभल जा, वक्त है अब भी बदल जा, मत कर एक दूजे पे हमला, कुछ ही दिनों का है जुमला।